Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to find the smallest and the largest element present in an array in C++. So I will be showing you two ways how you can do this. One is by using the normal for loop and another one is by using an inbuilt function. You can choose whichever method you want. So let's get started. So first I will go with a normal for loop, alright. So for this we will be inputting the array size and the array elements at first. So let's do that. So let int arr of 100 be my array, alright. So first we will be getting the n, that is the size of the array. So I will just put a comma over here and put n. So let me just have a C out saying enter array size. And let me just have a endl as well over here. And it's going to be C in n. And next thing, I will be using a for loop to get the array elements. So let me just now copy this and paste it. So I'll be entering over here, enter array elements over here, all right. And next thing is the for loop for inputting the array elements. So it's going to be for, let me have I over here, all right. Yeah, so I equal to 0, I less than n, which is our array size, I plus plus, and it's going to be C in arr of I, all right. So next thing, we will be using another two for loops to find the largest and the smallest element. So for that, we need to have two variables, alright. So it's going to be max and min to store the maximum and the minimum element. So it's going to be max, comma min, alright. So after this, just come over here. So I will just initialize my max variable value, alright. So first, I will be finding the largest element. So let max equal to arr of 0, alright. So this is just a random value. I'm just trying to assign a random value, alright. But this value can't be so random. It must be a element or a value that is present inside our array. So that's the reason why I'm assigning arr of 0. This can be any index number. Basically, it can be arr of 1, 2 or any other index element that is present within that array's range. So for this particular purpose, I'm using arr of index 0, alright. So next, I will just copy this for loop and I will just paste it over here. So instead of the C in, I will have this condition, alright, this if condition over here. So let me just first type the code and later I will just show you a demo how this works. So if max is less than our arr of I, what we will do is max equal to arr of I, alright, really simple. So now let me just show you a demo how this code basically works. So let's consider our array to be this, all right, arr equal to, let me go with 3, 4, 5, okay, let me go with 3, 4, 7 and 1, all right. So initially our max is equal to arr of 0, which is max is 3, all right. So let me just come here, max is going to be 3. So it will just come inside this for loop and in this if condition, all right, first it will check 3 less than arr of 0 because our I initial value is 0. So 3 less than 3, it will check. This condition is basically false. So this doesn't get initialized with some other value, all right. So this doesn't even go inside this if condition. So next thing, I value gets incremented. So this time 3 less than, it will check for arr of 1, all right. So which is 4. So this condition basically is true, all right, because 4 is greater than 3. So what happens here is that our max will be assigned to 4, all right. The reason is because 4 is greater than 3. So now what happens here is that our max value is 4 and it is not 3 as initialized. And next I value is getting incremented. I value becomes 2 over here. So max, our max is now 4 and arr of 2. Arr of 2 is 7. So this condition becomes true again and max equal to arr of 2, which is 7. So our max value now becomes 7. And it just goes here, max is 7, I value gets incremented, I value becomes 3, which is 1. So max is 7 and arr of 3 is 1 and if the condition is false, so it doesn't go inside it. And at the end, if we print max, we will be getting 7, which is the maximum element present inside our array. So this is how basically this code works. This exact code is same for finding the minimum element as well. So let me just now remove these comments, all right. So for finding the minimum or the smallest element, it's just the exact same code. So let me just now copy the same thing and let me just now paste it. So instead of max, I'm going to change it as min And instead of here as well, let me just change all the max to min. And instead of this lesser than symbol, we will be replacing it with greater than symbol. That's the only change between max and min. This also works the same way. So let me just also give you a quick demo of how this works. So let me just have the array as, I will go with the same array, all right, 3, 4, 1, and 5. So initially our min value is going to be here of 0, which is 3 over here, and it goes inside this for loop. The condition over here is that if min is greater than here of 5, so our min value initially is 3, here of I value is initially 0, so this particular element, so 3 greater than 3, the condition is false, so nothing happens over here. Next thing, I value gets incremented, I value is 1, so min, which is 3 yet again, so 3 greater than I value is 1, so error of 1 is 4, so it will be 4 over here. This condition is again false, so nothing happens over here. I value gets incremented, I value is now 2, so error of 2 is 1, so it comes over here, min, which is 3, and greater than error of 2, but error of 2 value is 1 over here, so it will be 1 over here. This condition becomes true for the first time, and what happens here over is that min equal to error of 2, error of 2 value is 1. So our min value is getting replaced by 1, which was 3 earlier. So now our latest min is 1 and it is not 3 as initialized. So this just goes off. Our min is now 1 and I value also gets incremented. I value gets incremented to 3. So which is error of 3 is 5. So it comes over here. Min value is 1. 1 greater than error of 3, which is 5. This condition is obviously false. So this if our for loop basically terminates, and at the end our min variable will be having the smallest or the minimum element, which is 1 in this case. So exact same thing, this only this greater than operator or less than operator changes between both the things, and only you need to just change the min and max variables. Pretty much simple, all right. So let me just now print, all right, let me just now come here and I'll just print. Okay, cout, I'll go with largest, and it's going to be max, and I'll go with cout smallest, and it's going to be min. All right, so let me just now save it. I hope it works. So compile and run. So first I will enter the array size, I will go with 6, and I need to enter the array elements. Let me go with 55 minus 100 minus 10, and let me go with 70 and 2 and 6. All right, so I'm having 6 elements, and if I just now hit enter, so here you can see I'm getting largest element as 70 and the smallest element as minus 10. You can just have a endl over here, all right, it is your choice, so this will work. So I think it's right, yeah, largest is 70 and smallest is minus 10, so this works perfectly fine. So this takes a time complexity of big O of n, all right. So this for loop takes n. Okay, we are having hit this for loop as well. So it's n plus n plus n. So it's big O of 3n, which like comes to big O of n, all right. It's like really time efficient, I guess. So if you feel this method is like really big, you have like many lines of code, you can just go with the second method, all right, by using the inbuilt function. So for this, we can basically just clear this out, all right. We can just have the input till the input. And for this, we will be using the sort inbuilt function, all right. And for this, we need to import this particular header file. So it's going to be include bits slash stdc plus plus dot h, all right. You need to have this particular header file to use the sort inbuilt function. So as usual, we'll be doing the normal stuff, getting the array size, the array elements from the user. And here is the main change, all right. We'll be using the sort function. So it's going to be sort your array name, which is arr in my case, comma arr plus n, which is the size of this array. I'll just go with n over here, arr plus n. That's it, all right. And here in for instead of max, we will be printing arr of n minus 1. I will just type the code and later explain to you, all right. And in the min, we will be having arr of 0. So this line of code basically sorts our array. So let's suppose say that I'm having an array, all right. So let this be my array. my array is going to be like initially this is going to be my array. We just cut it and paste it. It's going to be 3, 4, 7, 8. Let me go with 1. Yeah. So this is going to be my array. So after this particular sort function, it basically sorts our array in ascending order, that is from smallest to the largest. So after this particular code, it's going to be, my array is going to be like this, sorted. It's going to be 1, 3, 4, and 7. So after this particular sort, our smallest element is going to be the first element present in the array. And our largest element is going to be the last element present in the array. So for accessing the smallest element, we will be putting year of 0, which is going to be the smallest element after sorting our array. And to find the largest element, it's going to be the array length minus 1, because our array indexing starts from 0, alright? So it's 0, 1, 2, and 3. So if our array size is 4, it means that it has 4 elements. And the last element is going to be array size minus 1, as the indexing is starting from 0. So this largest element or the last element is going to be at present at the array size minus 1, alright? So in this case, the array size is 4, n is 4, and this 7 is present at index number 3. So that's the reason why I am doing n minus 1 over here to access the last element. So that's the stuff, alright? We are just basically starting the array and just printing the first and the last element to get the smallest and the largest element respectively. So let me just now remove these commands. I'm saving it and running it now. Yeah, I will go with 5 this time. I will go with 23, 45, 70, minus 3, and I will go with 5. And if I just now hit enter, so here you can see I'm getting the largest element as 70 and smallest element as minus 3. And if you want, I can also print the array, all right? So let me just now copy this. And let me just now paste it, and instead of seeing, I can also like see out. I'm in Python. Okay, see out error, and let me just have some space at the end as well. Yeah, this is fine. And let me also have a endl. So copy this and paste it. Paste it here as well. So now I'm just saving it and running it again. So I'll just zoom in a bit. So array size, I will go with 5. I will go with 50, 3, 4, minus 1, and 40. And if I just now hit enter, so here you can see I'm getting the largest element as 50 and the smallest element as minus 1. And this is the array that I have printed after it has been sorted, all right? So this particular statement output comes because of this particular statement, this for loop, all right? I'm just trying to print the elements. And here you can see the array elements are getting sorted. So this is what I told you earlier. Because of the sort, we will be able to access the first element is going to be the smallest and the last element is going to be the largest, and we're just accessing and printing it. And I think this method works even we have duplicate elements, all right? Even if we have 2 50s or 2 minus 1, the largest and the smallest elements are going to remain the same because we are sorting it. So this method is quite handy and it works most of the times. And it has like really less number of code than the earlier one, but I think it has a slightly high time complexity because we are sorting that particular array, all right? So you can choose based upon your need and time to choose whichever the method you want. And I hope you have found this video useful. I've also done many other programming videos in C++, C, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries, as well as 3D animation using Blender. So do check other videos off my channel, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.